We're back on Women of Style with Win-Win Ong, and I see some of your pieces. I'm very excited to see and hear about all of them, but this is just some of your masterpieces. I feel like when I look at your pieces, I can wear them on me, but also I can display them too in my home. So it really is a life adornment you can wear on yourself and also just see it. It doesn't have to be like just one facet.
I would hope so. I would really like that people see the pieces as a celebration of the hands that made them.
Yes.
And as a celebration of the concerted effort. It's a combination of everybody's art and everybody's ability to excel in their craft to produce this one piece. So, you know, whether you put it on a table for others to see or whether it's for your quiet enjoyment, I would like to think it brings at least a moment of happiness when
yes.
you see it.
But when it comes to your style, your fashion, what are the pieces that you are attracted to? Is it a color? Is it a cut? Is it a designer? Like, what are the pieces that you always gravitate to?
Style is... style has many definitions, and I don't think one can say a woman is stylish when she only wears haute couture. I think I have seen some of the most stylish women just wearing the simplest high street fashion. But I always think it is the force of a woman's personality. It's a character. If a woman is or a man is very sure and grounded about who or he is, who he or she is, it manifests itself. The confidence is there. It could be just one twist of a handkerchief. It could be the way you fling a jacket on your shoulder. You don't have to be formally dressed, but you can have style. And by the same token, you can be in some of the most expensive hand-stitched bespoke clothes and not be able to catch somebody's attention. It's really what you are and who you project yourself as.
When you do sometimes see that man or woman that you think, oh, this is a very stylish individual, are there anyone that you recall from growing up or who you know personally that you would revere as a style icon or a revered person that very stylish, knows how to put something together, or just knew that when you saw them you felt this person's got it going? Has there been anyone like that in your life?
Growing up, I remember seeing a book about Diana Vreeland. And back then, I remember the first thing, because I think I was a teenager, the first thing that came into my mind was, she's ugly beautiful. And ugly is a politically incorrect term, but I think you understand. She does not fit anybody's definition of beauty. And she knew exactly her own worth and how she projected that worth. So no matter what she wore, she manifested style.
Driven by her insatiable desire to create and to learn, she found herself pushing the envelope of her self-perceived boundaries, creating pieces that are an extension of herself, and unknowingly creating a brand and an artistry that will later on be celebrated by the country and the rest of the world. And with your style, Win-Win, how would you say is your fusion of who you are, the mix of Burmese, the mix of Filipina? Does that resonate in you, in your style?
I think I probably am a sum of all my parts, Joey. I think growing up in Europe helped shape some of that because, you know, they have a very different sense of what we consider style in Asia, right? And by the same token, like the Burmese sense of style, it's very, very different from the Filipino sense of style. So I think, you know, my bloodlines are Burmese, my mindset is very European and Western, and my spiritual affinity is to the Philippines. And I think every single person that I've encountered in my life has played a role in shaping who I am and my sense of style very clearly.